This will be the day that the United States resigned as the leader of the free world. It's nothing short of that. The irresponsibility of this act is breathtaking, because the Paris Climate Accords are actually extraordinarily flexible. They do not dilute American sovereignty. They allow every country to make its own plans. That's why countries that have jealously guarded their sovereignty, like China, like India, like Russia, have all signed on. There are 194 other countries that have signed on to this, including the countries that Donald Trump keeps saying always beat us in these agreements.
Let me interrupt for 1 second, Fareed, just because I want to ask. But what of the point made by Senator Paul and Stephen Moore here on the panel that China is getting away with murder, and don't listen to what the Chinese and the Indians are saying? Look at what they're doing. They're building more polluting plants.
Well, look, under any agreement, there is going to be some cheating. People accuse the United States of undermining the World Trading Organization rules all the time. And there's a process that you put in place to adjudicate this. And when they're found, there are, you know, they can be fines. The argument that they, you know, generically, that's a reason to never engage in any kind of cooperation. Look, if the Chinese were not signed on to the Paris Accords, they would be polluting many, many times more. There are also very good studies, one by the Grantham Institute, that points out that China is actually overshooting many of the targets it has arrived at. I also want to point out on this issue of jobs of the future, where I thought Van did an excellent job. The only thing I'd point out is it's 194 countries that are potential markets, not just 125. But the problem with the kind of statistics that Rand Paul and Steve Moore were providing is we all have Google. So from this January's Department of Energy report, United States solar industry employs more workers than coal, oil, and natural gas combined. It grew 25% last year. The point Van was making is exactly right. These are the industries of the future. These are the industries that the United States can dominate. As long as you are engaged in digging up oil, natural gas, that's open to lots of different countries around the world. It's not just the Middle East. It's Venezuela. It's Russia, the country that benefits perhaps most from all this. We would own the future if we could continue to dominate this. So it's bad geopolitically. It's bad economically. It does not dilute American sovereignty. This is a lose-lose-lose for the United States. And as I say, for a young presidency, it is already the single most irresponsible act that this president has taken.